प्रोफाइल ऑफ पंडित कन्हैयालाल मिश्रा एडवोकेट जनरल यूपी इंडिया 1952 to 1969. सोर्स: पंडित कन्हैयालाल मिश्रा माय फादर बाय मुनींद्र मिश्रा. Birth 31st August 1903 on Janmashtami at Mariatpur, Azamgarh, Uttar Pradesh, India. Occupation: Advocate. Post Head: Advocate General, UP, India 1952 to 1969. Expired on 14th October 1975, Dashera. After general elections were held for the first time in the United Province 1937, the Congress Party swept the polls and formed the first representative government in the province. Advocate Generals appointed thereafter till Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra are as follows: Dr. Narayan Prasad Asthana, first Advocate General 1937. Mr. Muhammad Wasim, second Advocate General 1942. Also the first Advocate General of Pakistan 1947. Mr. Pyarlal Banerjee, third Advocate General 1947. Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra, fourth Advocate General 1952. Resigned 1969. Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra was born in Mariatpur, district Azamgarh, UP, India on Krishna Janmashtami and was so named. He was the eldest of the four sons and one daughter of Pandit Bejnath Mishra, a top lawyer both in civil and criminal side at the Azamgarh Bar and an MLC for a long period of time. Pandit Kanhaiyalal Mishra had a shining educational career. He never stood second in his life. His schooling started at his village, then at Banaras, Varanasi, in the Theosophical School under Dr. Mrs. Annie Besant. He had an exceptional command over the Hindi, English and Urdu language. 1925, he graduated with honours in economics, securing 91% marks in English. 1926, he sat for the Indian Civil Service examination and created a record by securing 150 out of 150 in the English paper. However, due to his student day's speeches of freedom and his Mahatma Gandhi influence, he was not selected. 1927, passed his law examination and joined the district bar. 1930, October, shifted to the Allahabad High Court. 1942, imprisoned during freedom struggle in Naini Central Jail with Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Lal Bahadur Shastri and others. 1951, offered judgeship but on his request was not appointed. He attained eminence with flair of advocacy, depth of learning, sweet trapping court craft, humility and photogenic memory. His simplicity and brilliance were his landmarks. 1952, appointed Advocate General UP and continued till 1969, irrespective of political parties coming to power. 1955, offered Supreme Court judgeship, being the first advocate to receive such distinction without being a judge. However, he requested through the Chief Justice of Allahabad High Court, the Chief Minister and the Home Minister to spare him, which they did so reluctantly, as he wanted to be in public life, serving the institutions and public at large. 1969, resigned as Advocate General UP, the year his wife expired. He was a Chairman, Bar Council, President, Bar Association of Allahabad, President, Mehta Research Institute of Mathematics and Mathematical Physics, President, Prayag Sangeet Samiti, President, Hindi Sahitya Sammelan, Honorary Treasurer, Allahabad University and Member of its Executive Council, to name a few. He was a unique person, exceptional in all fields he touched or got involved in. He kept his emotions in total check, was soft-spoken, sober, kind, lived a very simple life and enjoyed it. He loved laughter, maintained a low profile and a high tradition. He was simple in dress of dhoti kurta and in thoughts, words and deeds. His concentration was immense and he demanded very little from life except books. He mixed freely with all and ever extended his eager hands, helping all in need. He left his mortal body on the 14th October 1975 on Dashera. His body, draped with the national flag, was carried to the Sangam, where rivers Ganga and Jamuna merge. With the setting sun, he was cremated with full state honors and the last gun salutes. His mortal and bodily strides now stood concluded. His final last journey was filled with people who loved, respected and cherished him. Some famous quotes on Pandit Kanhaiya Lal Mishra. Sir Arthur Quiller Couch, author: "It is the Englishmen who have conquered India, but it is only an Indian who has conquered English." Sri V.V. Giri, President of India: "When I was Governor of UP, I consulted thrice Mr. Mishra as the Advocate General. Twice I followed his advice, but once I differed. It was only later I realized that where I did not accept his advice, I had committed a mistake." Sir Earl Warren, Chief Justice, Supreme Court, USA: "I as a judge of the Supreme Court of the United States should not be emotional, but I must confess I have moved all over the world, but I was never moved more emotionally than by the speech of the learned Advocate General today." Justice S.R. Das, Chief Justice of India: "Mr. Mishra, why don't you more often appear in the Supreme Court? In the cases in which you appear, it raises the standard of our judgments." Justice Koraji, Chief Justice: "Irrespective of the decision in this case, I have never heard such an argument in my career at the bar and the bench." Mr. Sirvai, Senior Advocate: "When Mr. Mishra arrived and we had consultations, he was quiet. I thought the bulk of the argument is going to fall on my shoulders. But after hearing his brilliant arguments for several days, my feeling is, even if I add something more than what has been submitted, I would only be able to scratch or wash off the beautiful varnish put by him." Mr. Kanga, President of the Bombay Bar: "I have been telling my juniors for the last few decades how a case should be argued. But till Mr. Mishra arrived in this court, I could not give any practical example." Karpatriji: "After K.L. Mishra persuaded Shankaracharya of Puri to break his fast. We have heard about computers in the West. You put your questions and get ready-made answers, but never heard of a human computer, which we have found in Mr. Mishra." Sri S.N. Mulla, Senior Criminal Advocate: "Mr. Mishra never clamored for the front line. He took his seat wherever he found one, but he never knew. It was not the front bench, but wherever he sat that became the focus of attraction." Sri Shanti Bhushan, Law Minister of India and Senior Advocate: "He was such a versatile and noble man that the like of him may not be born again."
Thank you.